consortium members, and special invitees. A warm good morning to one and all. We welcome you all to this sylvan surrounding of Forest College and Research Institute, Medipalayam.
It indeed gives me great pleasure to introduce these all ourselves, particularly to the guests of honors today, the respected additional PCCM and the managing director Suresh Timbers. This college, though it was started as a humble beginning in the department, the year 1973 as a department, grown into a forest research station in the year 1976. Shortly we'll be coming to celebrate 50 years of Golden Jubilee in 2023. And during the journey of last 48 years, the institute has developed various systems. One of the major institutional development is the educational centre, the education system which has made 117 IOS officers who are serving across the country from Kashmir up to Kanyakumari. That's a major achievement this college has made. And equally, it has contributed almost 40% of the range of officers of Tamil Nadu Forest Department. Over and above, 50 scientists, they are working across the country in various SAUs and ICR institutes, and several people are working in Almalayan departments. That's a major introduction of this, academic introduction of this particular institute. And the second important thing is research arena. You know that TNAU, for the last 15 years, we have been doing what is called the value chain model. Like the success exhibited in agriculture system and horticulture system, we have developed a model called value chain on industrial agroforestry. That value chain on industrial agroforestry, first time, when the World Bank team, when they reviewed the one project, they were asking, how come value chain model can be created for forestry? Then we have said to them, the trees could also be harvested in terms of months, not in terms of years. That was said very clear. So, immediately they were hesitant to initially approve it, but a series of discussions. In 2008, we have got the project of value chain on industrial agroforestry in association with the paper industries and match industries. Across Tamil Nadu it has gone. Now what is you don't believe, this consortium is represented by 16 states in the whole country. We have a representative, Dr. Chavan from Punjab, Dr. Chandrasri is here. Similarly, Dr. Gandhi is from Jharkhand, representing UNCO, and Ms. Raj Jha also representing UNCO ITC. And similarly, South Indian almost match manufacturers association, timber associations, and wood-based industries, paper industries, TNPL and Sheshai Paper, because they are all our partners really. Because initially we started this program only with the paper industry. Based on the success, we have translated this to plywood industry, Sharan Plywood, AmbiPly. And now these all happened because two reasons. One is the farmers are able to attract through the agroforestry model. The farmers, you take, the entire Tamil Nadu, only 34 certified, almost everywhere. And these people have taken different role models. And for each and every zone, for example, Kaveri Delta zone, we have Mr. Satyamurthy. Satyamurthy has taken this different role. Northern part of Tamil Nadu, the Saravanan and other group have taken a lead. You name any species, Sandalwood, Shankar has taken a lead. So each and every species we have identified of people. Similarly, Vengai, an integrated farming model, Narasimhan from Thanjavur, Trichy, he has also taken a different model. So each and every people have taken a different model. And when we started this in agroforestry, it was only irrigated in the area. Another unique model is the Sheen Lac Queens, which has established 80 acres of Thailand agroforestry model in southern part of Tamil Nadu, the Kayathar. We always claim it's a driest part in the happening because of the eminent participation of farmers. As far as technological support is concerned, we develop our varieties. The varieties are in the whole country. I am equally proud to say TNA was the only institution in the whole country pronounced tree could be harvested in months. After that, several institutes have copied. That is the system. But this is the institute. We have to give a very big hand to TNAU because that's a very, very important system which we have made. Similarly, when we say initially 2004-05, we started only with the seed-based projects. This consortium has taken a very, ways and means. Down the line, another 3 to 5 years, this consortium will become, really, we say that it will become independent so that financially and managerially, this consortium will take a lead. It will set an example for the whole world, not only within the country, whole world, so that this model, recently also this model, our Honorable Vice Chancellor has inaugurated the international scientist meet. They have been attracted, world agroforestry has center has been attracted for only one reason. The reason is the consortium mode agroforestry promotion. Now everyone wants to replicate this consortium mode across India, and they are asking a lot of information. I have said very clearly, first go to the farmers, then go to the industries. Try to link these two people. with the technological intervention. That's a major facility we have made. And as a consortium leader and coordinator of this program, conceiver of this program, I'm really happy this is sustaining well. And down the line, years to come also, this will prosper very well in association with all your help and attitude. With this new background, I really, it is my honor and happy to welcome, respected my teacher and the head of the Tamil Nadu Agricultural University, the Vice Chancellor, for having immediately accepted when I say consortium immediately. Say. Normally, Vice Chancellor, whenever RSC, we just give a day, ask for a day, sir will say, bus yes. Then he will work out the modalities. So, definitely, we are all proud, sir, for your presence and all the consortium, on behalf of all the consortium members and on behalf of faculty members, it is my privilege duty to welcome the respected Vice Chancellor and leader of this consortium. Sir. I request the Vice Chancellor to please welcome the Chief Guest today, Mr. Sugata Abdul, the Adjunct Principal, to consider our pass. Happy to welcome on behalf of Varas College and on behalf of the consortium members to welcome the respected registrar. I request Suresh sir, please.
மலேசியா இந்த நாளிலிருந்து நாங்கள் டேரக்டாக வாங்கிட்டுருக்கோம். ஒரு 20 வருஷம் மரங்கள் வந்து லோக்கலாக பர்ச்சேஸ் பண்ணியிருக்கோம். மரம் வந்து நம்ம இங்கே ஏன் வாங்க முடியல அப்படின்னா அந்த தரத்துலேயே அந்த கெட்டத்துலேயே நான் நினச்ச மாதிரி மரங்கள் கிடைக்க மாட்டேங்குது. அதனால் வந்து நாங்கள் அதிகமாக வாங்க முடியல. நிறையா கட்சி பண்ணிக்கிறப்ப சாரோட அறிமுகம்தான் கிடச்சிச்சு. அவங்கள்ட்ட கவலையை தெரிவித்தோம். தெரிவித்தப்போ ஏற்கனவே வந்து பேப்பர் இண்டஸ்ட்ரீஸ் பேப்பர் இண்டஸ்ட்ரீஸ் தான் நாங்கள் பண்ணியிருக்கோம்ப்பா உங்கள் இண்டஸ்ட்ரீஸை நான் பார்க்குறேன்னு சொல்லிட்டு அங்கே ஒருத்தர் விஷயம் வந்து பார்த்தாரு. அவரை பார்த்து ஆச்சரியப்பட்டார். இப்போ சின்ன கிராமத்துலேருந்து இவ்வளோ நல்லா பெருசாக பண்ணுறீங்களே இவ்வளோ பண்ணுறீங்க அவங்களுக்கு வந்து இங்கே ஃபார்மர்ஸ்ட்டிக்கு வாங்கினா அண்ணே அண்ணே ஜெல்லாமணி போகிறீங்க ஃபார்மர்ஸ்ட்டுக்கு ஒரு மோட்டிவேஷன் இருக்கும் அவங்களுக்கு வந்து நல்ல விலை கிடைக்கும் அப்படின்னு அறிவிட்டுருந்தாங்க. எங்களுக்கு கிடைச்ச எங்களுக்கு நல்லது தானே நிறையா நிறைய மரங்கள் வாங்கிக்கலாம் வெளிநாட்டுலேருந்து வாங்குறதுக்கு எங்களுக்கு சரி அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு டைவர்ட் பண்ணாங்க. இது மூலமாக எங்களுக்கு வந்து ரெகுலராக வந்து மரம் கிடச்சிருக்குது அவங்களுக்கு நம்பிக்கை இருக்காது நம்ம மரத்தை ஈஸியாக வாங்கிடுவாங்க அப்படின்னு சொல்லுவாங்க. இந்த திட்டம் வந்து நல்லா எங்களுக்கும் பயனுள்ள விவசாயிகள் பயனுள்ள திட்டமாக தெரிஞ்சு இந்த பார்த்துக்கலாம் அவங்களுக்கு உறுதியான விலை கிடைக்கும் அப்படின்றதுக்காக நாங்கள் அதை டைவர்ட் பண்ணியிருக்கோம். இது மேலும் மூலம் நீங்கள் இப்போ பெருசு பண்ணி பெரிய அளவில் கொண்டு வரணும்னு நாங்கள் ஆசைப்படுறோம். நாங்கள் இதோட இதுவரைக்கும் கவர்மெண்ட்டோட சேர்ந்து டைவர் பண்ணி எதுவும் பண்ணதில்லை. நிறையா டோர்ஸ் மாடல் நிறையா டோர்ஸ் அப்டேட் பண்ணிக்கிட்டே இருக்கோம். கெமிக்கல் ட்ரீட்மெண்ட்டு ப்ளஸ் வந்து சீசனிங் ப்ராடக்ட் இதெல்லாம் போட்டு மரங்களை தரமாக கொடுத்து டோரில் எந்தெந்த மாடல் எவ்வளோ மாடல் நீங்கள் கேட்டாலும் எப்படி எப்படி மாடல் கிட்ட எங்களால் செஞ்சுருக்கக்கூடிய திறமையான ஆளுநர் சொல்லலாம். இப்போ அது இந்த கஜா புயலில் நிறையா மரங்கள் வாங்கி ஃபார்மர்ஸ் வாங்கி நிறையா பண்ணலாம். நிறையா இந்த மரத்தேவை நிறையா இருக்குது. ஃபார்மர்ஸ் இந்த மாதிரி வளர்த்து எங்களுக்கு டைவர் பண்ணி கொடுத்தீங்கன்னா நாங்கள் எங்களுக்கு உதவியாக இருக்கோம் உங்களுக்கு உதவி சொல்ல உதவியாக இருக்கோம்.
த்ரீ ஜெனரேஷன் டீச்சர்ஸ் ஆர் அவைலபிள் அவர் வைஸ் சான்ஸ்லர் அவர் டீச்சர் அண்ட் த டீச்சர் ஆஃப் டாக்டர் பாத்திமன் அண்ட் திரு என் ஜெயராஜ் ஐயப்பஸ் இஸ் த ஸ்டூடெண்ட் ஆஃப் டாக்டர் பாத்திமன். ஸோ திஸ் இட்செல்ஃப் ஷோஸ் the knowledge is transferred from one generation to another generation and this generation is equally working in a consortium mode. That's very important. The science is translated. When it is not translated, there is no use. So this is perfectly proved in this consortium. The scientists, the industrialists, the farmers, the line department officials and everybody is having equal breath in this forum. So that shows TNAU is achieved what it wants. With 100 odd years of history and different arena of science, TNAU is excelling. And this is one of the exemplified example because I have watched this since the concept note to consortium. Indeed, in the early part when the ICR was kind enough to give the NAIP value chain on agroforestry as a small part, I was contributing with my principal investigator Dr. Parthiban. And we all joined together. We used to visit myself, Dr. Natarajan, being in the plant protection. We used to visit all the farmers' fields. The enthusiasm they show, now it has come into a big way. So always aim big. That has been proved better. And Suresh Kannan equally told, we are very happy to work with the TNAU. This small beginning should not stop in India and it should be globally visible. That is the vision Dr. Parthiban is having. It's only because of team building. When we work together, we enjoy. Because everyone in the team has an important role. So that way, this is growing big and this message should be well taken care of by the Forestry Department. Our respectful additional PCCF is here and fortunately, Principal Chief Conservator of Forest, Dr. Durairaj Ayyappas, is also TNAU alumnus and he is my classmate. He is also showing lot of interest nowadays and he is member in Board of Management of TNAU. So that means the consortium is very big. Department, line department, Forestry Department is with us. So we sincerely take this message and forest cover is important in the entire country. So we are at it. Let us grow together like banyan tree. வளர்வோம் ஆலமரங்களைப் போல வாழ்த்துக்கள் வாழ்க பாரதம் நன்றி
Thank you sir
Start with wishing you a very very good morning
It's an old saying and I'm sure everyone here is aware
that forestry or the forests are the mother of agricultural groups and I think that is confirmed more strongly by the fact that it is this for agricultural university that now has infiltrated into the entire corner not only of Tamil Nadu in the form of the Indian Forest Service administrators, range officers, foresters and various other categories. Today it is equally gratifying to see that it is products from this very campus that are shaping the tree cover of the country through entrepreneurship, through funding agencies and of course in the form of the general public, that is the farmers themselves who are the most valuable in this entire chain of operations. A few words more about the relationship between the tree cover and the natural forests in the country. As you know, India as a nation has a distinction of being among the top 10 countries of the world with a forest cover. Of course, the classic countries are the huge, large countries like Canada, United States, Russia, and so on. That very naturally have a small population compared to us and therefore the natural forests are in great distribution. But it is a near miracle that a country of 1 billion plus inhabitants still has a natural tree cover, natural forested landscape almost touching 1/4 of its entire geographic area. We have taken a very conscious and valuable decision, I think, for our society to leave that natural forest intact for what we call ecosystem services. Namely, the extremely important and valuable function of providing unchecked water flow through various watersheds that originate in the forest. In fact, many, many years ago, when I worked in Kalakad-Mundanthurai Tiger Reserve, we had an extremely active program involving the local community forming partnerships to protect the forest.
And the first realization came when we spoke to them that they looked up to the forest not as a tiger sanctuary but as a river sanctuary. சிலவார்த்தைகள் நான் தமிழில் பேசுறேன். கொஞ்சம் மணிக்கணும் என்னுடைய தாய்மொழி தமிழ் இல்லை, அதனால வந்து அவரு திரும்பாக நான் பேச முடியாது. நான் வந்து திருநெல்வேலி மாவட்டத்தில் புலிகள் காப்பகத்தில் ஒரு ஈகோ டெவலப்மெண்ட் ஆஃபீஸராக போஸ்டில் இருந்தேன். ஒரு கிட்டத்தட்ட 20 வருஷம் முன்னாடி அந்த காலத்தில் நாங்கள் வில்லேஜ் ஃபாரஸ்ட் கமிட்டி ஃபார்ம் பண்ணோம். அந்த கமிட்டியோட முக்கியமான இது என்னன்னா, ஒரு ஒரு கோர் ஃபண்ட் வச்சு மைக்ரோ கிரெடிட் மூலமாக அந்த ஃபண்டை ரொட்டேட் பண்ணி வட்டியை வசூல் பண்ணிட்டு நம்ம வந்து மாற்று தொழிலுக்கு வரணும். அந்த காலத்தில் எந்த தொழில்னு கேட்டா, காட்டுக்குள்ள போய் விறகு வந்து ஹெட்லோடா கொண்டு போயிட்டு மார்க்கெட்ல விற்கணும். அது வந்து நம்ம காடுக்கு நம்ம விலங்குக்காக நல்லது இல்லை. ஆனா மக்கள் வந்து வேற தொழில் இல்லாம வேற வருமானம் இல்லாம ஒரு கம்பல்சரியா வந்து டெய்லி காடுக்குள்ளே போயிட்டு அதுதான் கேரி பண்ணிட்டு அதை வச்சுதான் அவங்களுக்கு வாழ்க்கை. நாள்தோறும் வந்து ஒரு 200 மக்கள் பார்க்கலாம். அவங்க வந்து வர வர இந்த மைக்ரோ கிரெடிட் பயன் பண்ணிட்டு ஒரு ஒரு சிறு தொழில், உதாரணத்துக்காக சிறு சின்ன சின்னது ஒரு இட்லி வியாபாரம், கட்பீஸ் வியாபாரம், அந்த மாதிரியெல்லாம் மாறிட்டு ஒரு பெரிய ஒரு கன்சார்ஷியம் மாதிரியே ஒரு குரூப் ஃபார்ம் பண்ணாங்க. ஒரு ஏறிக்குரிய 200 வில்லேஜ் ஃபாரஸ்ட் கமிட்டிஸ் சேர்ந்து இனிஷியல் கேபிட்டல் வெறும் ஒரு 3 கோடி, இன்னைக்கு அது வந்து 30 கோடி வரைக்கும் அவங்க ரொட்டேட் பண்ணி கொண்டு வந்தாங்க. வில்லேஜ் ஃபாரஸ்ட் கமிட்டியினுடைய ஒரே ஒரு என்னன்னா, சார் இது வந்து புலிகள் காப்பம் இல்லை, இது நதி சரணாலயம், அதனாலதான் இது வந்து நாம் காப்பாத்துக்கிறோம். There is a very big challenge in front of us, the country, and we do not wish to extract wood products from the natural forest. It's a way I am extremely delighted to see that. They know that a lot of the wood-based industries, for example, the big newsprint industries and so on and so forth, are importing a lot of timber from all over the world.
Yes, Sugumanan from Tirupur. Mr. A. Ramanathan from Pudukottai and Mr. Tirupathi from Virudhunagar to receive the agreement. The industry has formulated the basic support price for 6 timber species.
Sir.
Interacting with him directly, and by a via phone talk he has agreed, and that's why he is today here. Not only that, he has given a very good talk and the need for a good collaboration between State Department of Forest and the university. That itself has strengthened our hands. Actually, there is a what you call inherent feeling among many farmers that forest means no entry into the forest or things like that. So he has opened up many new ideas. I think that will definitely benefit. Then my registrar, Dr. Krishnamurthy, who is not new to Forest College, and the new generation dean, Dr. Parthiban, because this is the first time a student of this college, BSc Forestry background, is occupying the chair in forestry, for which I thank the State Forest Department, because normally they depute in their category of the Indian care of chief conservator of forest, but for want of personnel in their own department, they could not send and debute the search, and with the result, that post was lying vacant for many years. That hampers our research and education development. So this idea was supported, that's why Parthivan is there. My request to Parthivan is to take away, along with your people, and try to work for the science of forestry, which is now picking up in a great manner. And as far as the today's programs, namely the consortium of industrial agroforestry, the demand for forestry products or timber is growing up, as well as the firewood, it is going down because of the LPG and other things. I am from a village which is on the northern, so southern side of the Kalakad sanctuary, for information of the Mr. Dr. Dutt. If you climb down the peak of that, your Pavanasam Hills, this is my foothills of my village, wherein the practice was in 60s, 70s. Maybe 200 to 300 people go inside the forest and bring teak wood as firewood. In our village, this family people, this fellow is hardly bringing with heavy weight and other things. At that time, food is not available. Mostly for a one bundle of the teak wood firewood, they will give vessels of the food and other thing. That was the other day. So these people also, the family side, they will not also say this is not good. It is developing lot of there is a carbon smoke and other things. So that is the condition. Like the same village, I went there now. I used to go there now also. You cannot just enter into the forest because of the very good protective system. That's why Prime Minister also, in his open recent meeting, lamented the activity of our forest department, that it has grown from 18% to nearly 22% coverage, thanks to the good work done by the forest people. We should appreciate. So that requires lot of good personnel, for which also our forest college has contributed, as stated by many people. Our IFS officers are throughout India. If you go any forest divisions of any other states, our people will be there. So that's a prestige to this college. And again, recently we have given nearly 152 forest ranges to the state forest department. That was in the month of December they joined duty. So we are very glad that this college is coming up in a bigger way. That's the reason why from university side also we are supporting a lot on the infrastructure facilities. I remember in the 80s and all, this was started in a hut. Suresh is waving his head because he was the first person. They were sitting in the, cow shed to start this college. Now it has grown up in the very well, and it's all because of the good work done by many people. And today also I felt that when somebody is called here, they say cram. So there is a need for good hall, because forest garden will have many more programs. Last time we had the national seminar on agroforestry, why not international in the days to come? So facilities may not be available. So in our development plan, this will be one of the agenda, we will have it. And well, see, this is a good the consortium mode. Consortium mode, normally we hear in biological material, TNAE produces many consortium, wherein fungus, bacteria, and some actinomycetes, these are all plucked together and applied to the plants. The plant will grow without any disease or things. This consortium, we are bringing in scientists, production growers, processors, and marketers. At the same time, with assured prices. This is a very great one. In many of the agriculture article graph, there is no supportive price. Though MSP is there in certain cases, it is not. So, there is a guaranteed production. Because even the yesterday, we were having some meeting under the chairmanship of Chief Secretary at the Secretary, wherein there was a project was proposed for taking up agriculture in wasteland area and the non-cultivable area like this. These are all the areas wherein your agroforestry model can be taken up in a very good way. Or any tree species will not wait for years, the long gestation period, nobody having patience. Policy which we have given to our respected secretary to agriculture, I understand from him he has given to the forest secretary. So it is options of diversifications, and many people are having land. They cannot take up or look after the annual cropping crops because where it requires their attention, labor, everything. So this is another area wherein land absentee owners can engage themselves for the betterment of the our economy of the agriculture. So my request to the State Forest Department, wherein our additional PCCF is here, he will please put a word with our PCCF as well as secretary. Secretary also coming tomorrow to our university, because I have invited him specially to inaugurate the multifunctional agroforestry model which is developed at Metropolitan. But this is a site-specific one for the Metropolitan zone. What about your own multifunctional model, taking the components for plant species available in this area? Kilikudam, already they are going. Tomorrow we are launching at Coimbatore. I think this kind of model, if you develop, there will be an assured income to the small farmers. For the big farmers, of course, this consortium will be the mode, wherein production side, the required planting material has to be supplied by the decentralized nursery. I understand there are 12 nurseries, may not be adequate, as Mr. Suresh Kumar was telling that it is not adequate. So, but our current multiplication technology should be launched there, trained there, so that we will be able to meet the required one. Then the concept of the fertigation, other things has to be in the incorporated in the system, so that within a short cycle we will be able to get the program. And the one of the promising crop which Dr. Bharati is claiming is our bamboo, Bhima bamboo. He is from our own college. He is given to me in the college by 3 years, and he has been promoting this in northeastern area, Assam and other things. Whenever I contact him, he used to tell I am at Jorhat or I am at other thing or southeastern country, but it has not impregnated into south, especially in Tamil Nadu. So we have taken a decision in the university that we will take up multi-location trials of this Bhima bamboo in our area. So we allotted some area in MPP, lower Bhavani project area, so representing that by our Bhavani Sagar. In our Kilikudam, we are going in a big way. We already planted in Vaigai area, also in the high rainfall, namely Vechiparai, all of those things. So by doing this, so wherein university is going to make a partnership with the private industries aspect. So this kind of approach, I think definitely I am confident that this will come. Then while listening to the talk of Mr. Suresh Kumar, he was mentioning he is importing. Our PCC was also making a concern that importing means our money is going to other country. So Prime Minister is always saying, make India, trees ours. We have got lot of native trees. Since native trees are more in number, many people are not aware of that. To make the native trees important, this forest college, we have requested our honorable chancellor last time to initiate 1 lakh tree planting program, and he came all the way from Salem by road and inaugurated 1 lakh tree planting, and he also cautioned the dean that I will be again visiting and seeing the planting material. So planting and forgetting, I want to see 1 lakh tree growing. So that was the mission. I think they are taking in a positive way. Why I am telling is there are many, many native trees which are very good. It was not exploited, not having the required girth and quality. These are all the researchable issues. So within a short time, how can we bring that particular girth? There are technologies. What plants requires is a different kind of nutrients suiting to the different stages of its growth. So this kind of research, if you take up in the, you know, the days to come, definitely our growers will be able to develop very good material which you can harvest at the early days and other things. Dr. Bhartivan had given very extensive talk, that's why I have not taken anything from his transcription which he has given. He has covered very nicely. One thing I wanted to, I have got from his lecture is, many of the farmers coming from other states, they got very successful model, isn't it? My request is, you document that in a small film. TNA has got a YouTube, wherein if you fit it in 1 to 2 minutes program, this will go in a long way to educate the farmers, because our university, if you see, more than 20 lakhs viewers are there in our website. So this is a model, this is a method of propagating our technology. Again, my request to Spartivin is, this kind of consortium meet, you next time have it, beyond our boundary. Don't think you are with the Tamil Nadu. Now, many people are coming from other states, means you consider on, say, suppose Maharashtra is doing very well, you do it, because Maharashtras are the leaders in many crops. Grapes, they have made tremendous progress. In mangoes and oranges, like this. So, when you take up this kind of activities outside, then the entire country will also have a new look on the agroforestry system. You please thoroughly discuss, because there will, whenever there is a program, there will be some negative aspects or some divisions will be there, that you have to work out through negotiation, discussion, and so that this consortium will mutually help all the stakeholders of this very valuable consortium, because this is the first of its kind, I think. So the first of its kind should be the model for all in India. With these few words, I wish you all the best, and also thank you for the opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your thought-provoking words.
As growing trees is the passion of our Vice-Chancellor. It was evident in many occasions. The first occasion in Forest College, that 1 lakh tree planting, the 1 lakh mass tree planting. The second occasion, it was well evident in the establishment of Oxygen Park with our Dr. Bharati sir, the famous bamboo. We expect all the offices to grow trees. So growing tree is the mantra, and also used to say, you grow trees, you may grow along with the trees. So that is how Vice-Chancellor used to say. So much of idea and how to get the fund from CAMBA. I think we can get many funds from CAMBA. I think SAG may help us to our university. With the request on behalf of everyone, I thank the Chief Justice Sir, Dr. Dasar. Thank you, sir. I always used to talk about my course only, because that's the passion our history is having. On behalf of all the delegates, all the staff members and consortium members, I thank our Vice Chancellor, Mr. Suresh Miller. I would like to thank the consortium leader, Dr. K.T. Bhartivan. I used to say, Villuthi Vijayan, Solluthu Bhartivan. Because whatever he says, he will do. He always works on the commitment. Though he became the dean yesterday, up to 12 o'clock night, he was with me. He was at the R. Group of Sri department people. So he will not see the difference whether he is a dean or professor, head or professor. He always along with us, he motivating us, he is inspiration for us. So on behalf of all the consortium members, it is my proudest privilege to thank Dr. Ketu Karthikan, the dean. Not only dean, also, Madam Dean also.